subscribe Tag TV YouTube channel and press the notification button.
Good evening. Welcome to South Asia Newsline. I'm Yeshi Chanzo. Here are the top stories we are tracking for you on Tuesday, the 24th of August. India evacuates over 70 people from Afghanistan. More flights expected. LETJM terror outfits hold pro-Taliban victory rallies in Pakistan-administered Kashmir. And Sri Lanka turns to affordable and green cardboard coffins amid rising COVID-19 deaths. And now for all the details. Continuing its Afghanistan evacuation mission, India on Tuesday brought 78 people, including 25 Indian nationals and a number of Afghan Sikhs and Hindus to Indian capital, New Delhi. So far, more than 600 people have been brought to India amid the evolving situation in Afghanistan after Taliban's takeover.
India on Tuesday evacuated 78 people, including 44 Afghan Sikhs and 25 Indian nationals, and 3 copies of the Sikh holy book Guru Granth Sahib as part of its Afghanistan evacuation mission. India's Union Ministers Hardeep Singh Puri and V. Muralidharan received the holy scriptures along with the evacuees, who reached New Delhi from Kabul on a special Air India flight after a stopover in Dushanbe. Officials said so far more than 600 people, including 228 Indians, have been airlifted from the war-torn country following the Taliban's takeover, and more flights are expected in coming days.
The total number of people who have been evacuated are 626. Isme hamare nagrik jo hain, जिनको हमने इवैक्यूएट किया है वो 228 हैं।
Meanwhile, Afghan refugees in India continued their sit-in protest for a second day outside the office of refugee agency UNHCR in New Delhi. Their demands include refugee cards, resettlement options to a third country, and security from the international bodies and the Indian government.
हमारा जान सेफ्टी है, मगर खाना पीना के वजह से हमारा जान सेफ्टी नहीं है। सिर्फ हमारा जान सेफ्टी है, हम भारत सरकार से थैंक यू बोलेंगे कि हम सेफ्टी में रहेंगे, मगर यूनिसेफ का ऑफिस के ऊपर प्रेशर डाले भारत सरकार, ताकि ये हमारा परेशानी दूर करे, सबके परेशानी दूर करे, क्योंकि लोग बहुत परेशान हैं।
India is home to thousands of Afghan refugees and students who live in various settlements across New Delhi. Indian authorities have also begun granting of emergency e-visas to Afghan nationals who want to come to the country in view of the prevailing crisis in Afghanistan.
Security forces on Tuesday neutralized 3 terrorists in an encounter in Sopore town of India's Union Territory of Jammu and Kashmir. Based on specific inputs, a cordon and search operation was launched in a village in Sopore on Monday night. The security forces zeroed in on the spot where terrorists were hiding and came under heavy firing that triggered the encounter. Police said a huge cache of arms and ammunition was also recovered from the encounter site. This came a day after 2 top commanders of the Resistance Front, affiliated to Pakistan-based Lashkar-e-Taiba terror outfit, were gunned down in another encounter in Srinagar district. India has long accused Pakistan aids terrorists infiltrate across the border to spread unrest in Kashmir Valley. Pakistan, however, denies the charges. Moving on, 2 of the most dreaded terrorist organizations, Lashkar-e-Taiba and Jaish-e-Mohammed, carried out several pro-Taliban rallies in Pakistan-administered Kashmir recently, as their fighters, who had reportedly gone to fight alongside the Taliban against the Afghan government, returned home. In footages out in the public domain, the terrorists could be seen embracing each other and firing shots in the air in celebration in the illegally occupied region. Over the years, The two terror outfits have primarily focused on India, where their missions involve carrying out direct terror attacks and sabotaging of New Delhi's interests. India and Afghanistan have long blamed Pakistan's shelters terrorists, and its intelligence service trains them to use as proxy to mount cross-border attacks.
Of Pakistani occupied Jammu Kashmir based Taliban, who had gone to Afghanistan on the instructions of ISI and Pakistan Army to fight alongside the Taliban, have started to return to Pakistani occupied Jammu Kashmir. And yesterday, dozens of these Taliban youth have arrived in Pakistani occupied Jammu Kashmir, especially in Abbaspur, in Hajira, in Sensa district, and they are terrorizing the local population.
In news from Afghanistan, while evacuation operations from Afghanistan are ongoing, thousands of Afghans continue to crowd outside of Kabul's airport, waiting to flee the country, ahead of a deadline set for August 31st. The Taliban have said they will reject any demands by Western forces to extend the deadline to allow more time to complete the evacuation operation.
Thousands of Afghans continued to crowd outside of Kabul's airport on Tuesday, waiting to flee the country ahead of a deadline set for August 31. Widespread chaos, punctuated by sporadic violence, has gripped Kabul airport, with Western troops and Afghan security guards driving back crowds desperate to flee following the Taliban's takeover of the Afghan capital on August
15.
Taliban warned on Monday there would be consequences if the United States and its allies extend their presence in Afghanistan beyond next week. Taliban spokesman Suhail Shaheen told Sky News on Monday if the US or UK were to seek additional time to continue evacuations, the answer is no. US President Joe Biden said on Sunday that he would not like to extend the deadline for evacuations, but the talks were ongoing. Meanwhile, top UN human rights official Michelle Bachelet said on Tuesday that she had received credible reports of serious violations committed by the Taliban in Afghanistan and urged the UN Human Rights Council to set up a mechanism to closely monitor Taliban actions.
In particular, we have also received credible reports of serious violation of international humanitarian law and human rights abuses taking place in many areas under effective Taliban control. They include, among others, summary executions of civilians and all the combat members of the Afghan National Security Forces, restrictions on the right of women, including the right to move around freely and girls' right to attend school.
She urged the Taliban to honor commitments to respect the rights of women and girls and ethnic and religious minorities and refrain from reprisals. The UN Human Rights Council is holding an emergency session at the request of Pakistan and the Organization of Islamic Cooperation to set up a mechanism to closely monitor Taliban actions.
Moving on to news from Pakistan. Residents, traders and local businessmen in Pakistan's border towns have expressed concerns over a possible influx of Afghan refugees that they said would increase their woes. Locals said there was already a lack of infrastructure, with hospitals overcrowded due to number of refugees already there.
Residents, traders and local businessmen in Quetta, a border town in Pakistan, expressed concerns on Monday over a possible influx of Afghan refugees that they said would increase their woes. Locals said there was already a lack of infrastructure in the town, with hospitals overcrowded due to the number of refugees already there. With dramatic images of frantic evacuations emerging from Afghanistan post-Taliban takeover, fears that Afghan refugees could start spilling over the border are increasing in Pakistan's border towns.
Phir majar log aa jayega to aur mushkilat badh jayega pehle to aspatalon mein itna rush hai majroon ki wajah se border ki wajah se to aur hamara mushkilat badhega
Meanwhile, scores of Afghans continued to cross over to Pakistan on Monday via the Chaman border. They said the situation was unpredictable back in Afghanistan. Pakistan is already home to over 1.4 million Afghan refugees, according to UN Refugee Agency data. In July, Pakistan's information minister had said Pakistan would not allow any new Afghan refugees to enter Pakistan's heartland, with the government instead planning on establishing refugee camps near the border.
Moving on to news from Sri Lanka. Amid the pandemic, Sri Lanka has been reporting record-high coronavirus-related deaths lately. The cardboard coffin made out of recycled paper and cost a sixth of the cheapest wooden casket has now become a viable option for poor families. It has also become increasingly popular among those who are more environmentally conscious. At a box factory in Dehiwala, Mount Lavinia City, neighboring Sri Lanka's capital of Colombo, workers are busy assembling a special product, cardboard coffins. The coffin is made out of recycled paper and cost a sixth of the cheapest wooden casket, according to the 51-year-old Priyantha Sahubandhu, the local government official who first came up with the idea. With Sri Lanka reporting record-high coronavirus-related deaths lately, the cardboard coffin has become a viable option for poor families because of the high price of wooden coffins.
සියක් විතර මරණ ඇති වෙනවා සාමාන්‍ය මරණ. ඒ සඳහා පෙට්ටි 400ක් කියන්නේ ගස් 250 300ක් විතර දවසකට කපන්න ඕන වෙනවා මේ සඳහා. අන්න ඒ පරිසර විනාශය අවම කිරීම සඳහා concept එකක් විදිහට මම 2019 වර්ෂයේ සෞඛ්‍ය කමිටුව ඉදිරිපත් කළා.
The coffins are mainly ordered and delivered to customers by the Dehiwala Mount Lavinia Municipal Council for $22.50. Initially, the coffins were mostly used for COVID-19 victims, but they have become increasingly popular among those who are more environmentally conscious, Sahabandhu said. Sri Lankan President Gotabaya Rajapaksa announced a total lockdown last Friday for 10 days to curb a renewed surge in COVID-19 cases driven by the spread of the highly transmissible Delta variant. The country recorded its highest daily death toll of 198 on Friday, while total fatalities have reached 7,560. Hundreds of devotees crowded the Kathmandu Darbar Square in Nepal's capital on Monday to mark Gai Jatra Cow Festival, which people believe will give salvation to the souls of their departed loved ones. On the occasion, family members or relatives of those who have passed away take out processions wearing old costumes and remember the departed souls.
Amid the COVID-19 pandemic, scores of devotees gathered in Kathmandu Darbar Square in Nepal's capital on Monday to celebrate Gai Jatra or Cow Festival, which people believe will give salvation to the souls of their departed loved ones. It is believed that the festival derives its name from the religious belief that the deceased, during their journey to heaven, cross a legendary river by grabbing the tail of a cow. On the occasion, family members or relatives of those who have passed away dress themselves as cows and go around the city wearing odd costumes to remember the departed souls. Bereaved families offer fruits, bread, beaten rice, curd and money to those participating in the procession.
यो हरेक घरबाट दिवंगत आत्माको चिर शान्ति कामना होस् भनेर यो गाई यात्रा निकालिएको हो यो चाहिँ नि मेरो मम्मी बितेको अहिले एक वर्ष भयो उहाँको सम्झनामा उहाँको आत्माले चिर शान्ति कामना होस् भनेर मैले गाई यात्रामा हिँडिरहेको छु
Gai Jatra is celebrated mainly by the Newar community on the first day of the waning moon in the month of Saun and Bhadra as per the lunar calendar. The festival is also marked with the mockery of the wrongdoings of the politicos and other concerned groups through the means of drama, music and other means.
Well, that's all we have for you from South Asia this evening. Now our viewers can watch the show on southasianewsline.com. You can also visit us on facebook.com/asianewsline and follow us on Twitter @asianewsline. That's all in tonight's edition. We will see you same time tomorrow. Good night.
TAG TV brings you daily news bulletin from India. Breaking news and views from India.